There's something about this place, I don't know what it is, you can't quite put your finger on it, but it stirs like a creative force in people.
There's a strength in austerity here, which clarifies your ethics and your desires in terms of what you think you need to have a great life.
For someone like me that works in restaurants, there was a lot of opportunity for me to have my own place and have my own thing. I came from LA and New York, so it's a place that you can actually build something on your own.
It's definitely a slower pace. There's a lot of attention paid to the landscape and the skies and kind of what it does to you in a cosmic sense.
If you step outside at night, you know that nobody's looking at you, and you can walk a certain direction and you won't run into anyone, and you can see millions or maybe billions of stars. And you can just see the Milky Way like glowing and just stars all around it and all the way to the horizon.
Marfa started to become a destination for more than just art enthusiasts. What really kicked that off was when El Cosmico came to town.
El Cosmico has been a great force for all sorts of creativity and great folks coming to visit. And I think Liz's enthusiasm and kind of just boisterousness has kind of helped everything in Marfa and West Texas.
When we first began, I think we had two trailers. And so it really began organically. Over the years, it's grown to be about 43 units. It's tents, yurts, variety of different kinds of trailers.
El Cosmico breathed a new culture into town. They were cultural vagabonds. They wanted to see new things. They wanted to camp in the desert. El Cosmico more or less brought the party to town.
Through Liz's vision and what she's done, she's made it a real destination. Whether you're an artist or not, it just is a good place for young people to come.
I'm inspired by the new creatives that are showing up here, the new music scene that's coming here, the new food scene that's coming here. You know, what Liz Lambert's building and what she's doing with ICON, I think is so exciting.
So there's a lot of serendipity involved in the way that this project came together. For me, one of the all-time heroes of modern architecture is BIG-Bjarke Ingels. When Liz realized she wanted to reimagine El Cosmico, she reached out to BIG-Bjarke Ingels and to BIG because of the reputation of that firm. And very quickly, when he realized that Liz was from Texas, this was going to be in West Texas, he said, "Do you know this guy, Jason? Do you know, have you heard of ICON?" And she had not. And so BIG-Bjarke convened the three of us together, and it immediately became this sort of collaborative tour de force, and it has been just such a joy to put these technologies into the hands of a great visionary like Liz and a great form giver like BIG-Bjarke to bring this project to life.
We finally get to develop a lot of the amenities we've been dreaming about for years. I've always wanted a bathhouse out there, and we've always wanted this huge pool. We've always wanted a restaurant. We've wanted more facilities to be able to do art, art studios and workshops and places to gather.
One of the upgrades to the new El Cosmico that I'm most excited about are these Sunday homes. 2, 3, 4 bedroom homes that people can buy and own in a more committed way to really be a part of, with some permanence, the El Cosmico life.
Community has always been incredibly important to El Cosmico. And having people that actually have ownership in the bigger property and are invested into the community for more than just a weekend is, I think, really important to the bigger project.
Marfa was already cool before we ever got here. But one of the things Liz really keyed on was the sort of essential earthiness of Marfa. A lot of the primary buildings in town were built with like adobe and mud and straw in the local rocks. And even though we're now building with these advanced technologies and these advanced materials, they're kind of like a close cousin of adobe, of sand, of rock, sort of reimagined in a more advanced form, but sort of the essential characteristics still come through in the way that we're building now.
Taking this technology that ICON has and actually printing homes with dirt, water, and a binder, it is gonna be just like it's rising from the desert floor. I mean, I never would have imagined it, right? I wouldn't have imagined that we could build a second version of El Cosmico and actually use something that is such an ancient way of building, but also absolutely the future